Welcome to Links to Leadership, an insider's guide to what makes for a good business relationship, with iconic business leaders and CEOs who share their secrets for success.
Take me back to 1980. Tell me the story of the webbed warrior.
Oh, the little duck. Oh, that was amazing. I asked Glenn Hilton one day, in just conversation, after selling duct tape now for about 6 years, I say, Glenn, where did this stuff come from? Just a question. He says, duct tape was invented in World War II to be used as a sealing tape to be shipped on the decks of carriers to seal munitions boxes that were going to be shipped on the deck of destroyers and carriers to speed them overseas faster. He said, what do you think the boxes were marked, Jack? I said, I don't know, Glenn, because it was DUCT tape in our now. He says, D-U-C-K, it's duck cloth. It's made out of this tightly woven fabric that'll shed water. Then they put some polyethylene on it, green, army green, but polyethylene to make it further waterproof. Then they drove it into with a natural rubber adhesive, and the GIs used it for everything. Their bandages, airplane wings, shoes, everything they could do, they used it for. So it hit me, oh my God, if I could ever get the trademark for the original Duck, D-U-C-K tape, I could build a brand and nobody could follow me.
True or false, you rejected over 3,000 ducks because you didn't like the eyes. You thought the eyes were too mean.
I did. Yeah, and the first order came in and there was these ducks had, instead of a smiling eye, I rejected every one of them. I said, no way, we're not going to sell these. So I sent it back. I called a guy in Korea, and the guy on weekends was a Elvis impersonator. He loved singing Elvis songs. He was a great guy, and he owned this factory that made all these ducks. You're right, Jack, you're right. Send them all back. I'll replace the eyes. So 3,000 ducks got their eyes replaced with a pair of smiling. Because where you place that really can go mean or happy, depending on where you do it. But if you don't have quality control of your own mascot, you have nothing.
And true or false, it took a while to come up with the right color scheme, not only for the duck, the web warrior, if you will, but something that could unify your product line and draw attention to the excellent Menco product.
Sea of green. Green comes from the English language, meaning green with jealousy, green with envy. It has a negative meaning. Our lights are green. Our money is green. Our grass is green. The leaves of the trees are green. You know, we're losing them in the fall. I want green. I like this color 357. It's just a particular color that met my eye. And I wanted two stripes of fire orange and yellow, which are the two colors that go into your eye once you study eye development. First, the reason why so many things are yellow for little kids, it's the first color that goes into their iris. It's also the last color as older people that you see. I trademarked Sea of Green, and I advertised off of that. I would put ads in the magazine. If you want to join the Sea of Green in profit, put our products in your store. So it became a very popular thing, but it bucked. It's something I've done all my life, I think. I usually buck convention. And I try to prove him wrong. Sam was a bucker, too. I'm not trying to take any credit from learning it from Sam. But I like to go my own route. And if I'm right or wrong, I'll live with it.
Here in your spectacular home on the shores of Lake Erie, out by the lake, flies the American flag. And below that, right, the green Menco flag.
Green duck flag.
With the duck. Mm-hmm. Safe to say, Carnegie, right? Dale Carnegie in feathers?
How to win, yeah. How to Win Friends and Influence People, the first book my father ever gave me. Dale Carnegie, a cowboy that drove through Idaho and everything, making friends off of his horse. Cool guy.
Does the duck have a name?
Menco T. Duck. And we write a newsletter 6 times a year. I used to write a newsletter, front and back cover, that was designed to give you a bad night's sleep. That was my design, my purpose. Sam Walton loved it so much, he'd say, Jack, do you mind if I copyright that? Can I have permission to make copies? Because he was sending it to more people. I said, send it to as many people as you want. So that's our Menco T. Duck signs that. And they'd say, we'd wait for him to say, well, who is T? What's his middle name? Trust. Menco Trust Duck. You can trust the duck.
That's this edition of Links to Leadership with the man that made Menco and duct tape household words, Jack Kay. I'm Jim Kelly. We'll see you next time.